Top eight at eight. Let's do it. The segue was so good for this one because it's the top eight quarterbacks, college quarterbacks of all time. But we did it in draft form. Mm-hmm. And so these are actually our fourth picks coming first. And then we're going to go backwards until where we basically made our number one overall picks. My fourth pick, I'm surprised you didn't go earlier, is the man you can see on the screen there, Tim Tebow. Highly accomplished college quarterback. He did it all. Ran through the famous jump pass touchdowns. A lot of heart. Was an emotional leader. He was an incredible college quarterback. So he was my fourth pick. And we're coming backwards here. So who do you have? So
my fourth was Cam Newton at Auburn.
Cammy Cam.
When he was at Auburn, I mean, he was only there for one season. So, you know, it's kind of a small case study, I think.
Right.
But it's really hard to devalue. You know, I think they went 14-0 on their way to the national title. I think he had 4,000 total yards of offense mm-hmm. that season. And what comes to mind when I watched him play in college, and I think that's still true today, is just smooth. It just, everything mm-hmm. looks smooth with him.
Here's a guy I mentioned, speaking of transcendent, another guy I'm surprised still was available, but Danielle just kept surprising me with her picks here. I'm just kidding. Is Mike Vick. Another guy who is a once-in-a-generation quarterback who just blew my mind with the things that he did in college. It was like watching, I mean, there were some games where it just felt like you were watching backyard football, the way he was just able to, if a play fell apart, he could still navigate through defenses and just do incredible things with a cannon arm and the ability to make some throws and runs that were just incredible.
Next on the list for me is Vince Young. When he was at Texas, mm-hmm. and really this was kind of maybe almost a bad way for me to pick this, but all I thought of when thinking of him was that 2005 Rose Bowl against USC when
it's
he ran for
to.
That like for that touchdown. And I mean, I know there's so much more to his career even, and that season was when they were 11-0 and he was an All-American, but when I think Vince Young, it's that play right there in that game.
Yeah. Okay, well, my second pick in the college quarterbacks draft, so to speak, was Lamar Jackson. That's how highly I think of him. The guy went back to New York City a second time after winning the Heisman the first time. And it's so not shocking, but it's so disappointing, I think, for Louisville and Louisville football, the fact that they went 17-9, I think, with him as their starting quarterback over the past 2 years. Very disappointing, considering how good he was.
And moving on to my second pick, this is my West Coast bias showing a little bit, but John Elway from Stanford.
That was a great photo.
He kind of looks like a little bit of a goon in that photo, but we'll ignore that. But, I mean, what he did at Stanford was just incredible, and I also have great sympathy for any guy who had the final game of his college career interrupted by the Cal marching band.
Yes.
That was the game with the play, if you guys recall, where the band stormed the field before the game was actually over.
Yes.
And
famous.
Yeah, Elway has only now just started, I guess, to get over it and think that it's funny. He's said in interviews he was pretty mad at the time when it happened. Because I think they were 5-5. They needed to win that game, so that was pretty bad.
Okay, my number one pick, I'm going to go with Peyton Manning. Still shocking to me that he did not win the Heisman Trophy, but unbelievable college quarterback, and then went on to the NFL to become the third greatest quarterback in NFL history. Behind, of course, Joe Montana and the GOAT of all sports of all time, Tom Brady. All right, who you got? Who's
my
the number one overall pick?
My number one right away was Tommy Frazier from Nebraska. Still the only player to ever get MVP in three national championship games.
Yeah,
so
it's pretty impressive.
That speaks for itself, I think, because you can have someone, as we've seen with Lamar Jackson, they can have the most amazing season ever. They can, you know, be Heisman runner-up, but they can still really not get any conference honors. Or I think Lamar was only, second team All-American, right? He wasn't even first team.
Yes.
So to get, I mean, unanimously to get national championship MVP three times, I think that holds you above the rest.
I think that airbrushed Huskers sweatshirt alone is enough to propel him into the top two picks, top pick overall. In my top 8 at 8, and your top 8 at 8. So, okay, well, that was fun. Thanks for entertaining me with that.